The first tutorial in Java programming. In this module, we will learn how to do Java programs using Bluejay. So, first, let me have a brief introduction of Java. Java is a high-level language which was developed by James Gosling and team. It was developed by Sun Microsystems and it was released in 1995. Java is an object-oriented programming language that runs on a variety of platforms. It can run on Windows, Mac, or Mac OS, Linux, Unix, etc. So it is a platform-independent programming language and it's a very robust programming language. Let's talk about the history of Java. Java was developed by James Gosling and team. It was developed in the laboratory of Sun Microsystems. Originally, it was named as Oak, but later on, due to some copyright issues and some other problems, they had to rename this product and it was later named as Java. Java was developed or released in May 20, 1995 by Sun World. The first Java-enabled web browser was Hot Java. There were many versions of Java like J2SE, J2ME, J2EE. Many versions of Javas are there. Next, we'll talk about the characteristics of Java. Java is a very simple language. It is object-oriented. Object-oriented means it includes the concept of object-oriented programming in which every program module is divided into small modules which are known as object. Java is a distributed language which can be distributed across multiple platforms. Java is interpreted. Interpreted means Java uses an interpreter which converts this high-level language to a low-level language. Java is a robust programming language. This means that when we are working in Java, we have certain errors and every error is rectified. Means there is a solution for each and every error, whether it be a runtime error or it be a syntax error. Java is a very secure language. It is architecturally neutral. Java is portable. That means Java program follows the concept of Vora. That is, write once, run anywhere. It can run on any platform. And it is multi-threaded. It has a feature of multi-threading. And it's a very dynamic language which can be used in any platform for any purpose. So these are the few characteristics of Java I have already discussed. Next, we'll talk about the types of programming languages. See, first, programming languages can be categorized into two categories. First is high-level language and low-level language. High-level language, on the basis of their paradigm, it can be categorized into two categories, that is procedural language and OOPs. Procedural language means the language in which the stress is given on the procedure, that means the functions. And object-oriented programming, the stress is given on the objects. This we'll be dealing in the next module. Low-level language can be further categorized into two categories, that is machine-level language and assembly-level language. Machine-level language, which are written in the form of zeros and ones, and assembly-level language is written in the form of mnemonic codes. So these are the languages which are written at the low level, which are directly connected to the computer hardware. Next, we'll talk about high level language and low level language. High level language are languages which are mainly used for programming and it has English like keywords. They're easy to understand. For example, we can have Java, C++, Python, etc. And low-level language includes the machine-level language as well as the assembly-level language. Low-level language are written in the form of zeros and ones, and they are machine-dependent and they are directly contacted with the machine, that is the hardware part. High-level language includes many languages like ASP.NET, C#, C++, Java, Oracle, FoxPro, Python. These are all high-level languages which are written in English-like keywords. So if we talk about the methodology of programming languages in high-level language, it has two methodologies. First is procedural language, and second is object-oriented programming. A procedural language is a computer language that follows a set of commands, and it mainly stresses on the procedures. is a modular approach in which the program is divided into small modules called objects. So let's take an example. Like procedural language is written in the form of, you can say, essay. So here it is written in a sequential manner and the execution also continues in a sequential order. But in case of object-oriented programming language, entire program is divided into small modules and these modules are called as objects. Let us consider an example. Like suppose I want to prepare a game, can say car racing game, in which I have different cars, drivers and all. So in that case, if I do this with the help of procedural language, in that case everything has to be written in the form of text. And in there, if I want to make some changes, like suppose I want to change white car with red car, so wherever I have used red car, I have to make the changes. And if I continue this with object-oriented programming language, here I'll make one object, one module for cars, one module for drivers, one module for environment, one module for controllers, one object for graphics, and one for tracks. Now here it's an object-oriented programming, and here if I want to make some changes, like instead of using white car I want to use red car, so I'll make changes only in this object. The other objects remains unchanged. So it is very easy to debug things. Debug things means it is very easy to make changes to rectify errors. But if we talk about this procedural language, if any error occurs due to suppose one red car, so wherever there are red cars, so everywhere I need to make the changes. I have to check each and every place where the error is. But in case of object-oriented programming, it is a very robust language, and here we can easily make changes, we can easily debug the errors. Next, we'll talk about the features of OOPS. First, we'll know what is an object, class, encapsulation, data abstraction, inheritance, and polymorphism. So let's discuss these things. Any real-world entity which has some attributes and that shows some function is called an object. For example, let us consider a mobile phone. A mobile phone has some characteristic, like it has some display, it has battery, it has many objects inside this, many interface. So these are called the attributes. And function, you all know it. A mobile phone can be used for multimedia purpose, it can be used for clicking pictures, it can be used for calling. So these are the functions. So any real world entity which has some attributes and which shows some function is called an object. In case of computer language also, any entity which has some data as well as some function. Next, we'll talk what is a class. A class is a group of interrelated objects. A class is also called an object factory because all the objects are created within a class only. Like suppose, let us consider an example, like car is a class, and BMW, Audi, Ferrari, these are different models, different. So these are called the objects. So all the objects are created within a class only. That's why object is often referred as instance of a class. Next, I'll explain you what is encapsulation. Encapsulation means wrapping up of data and functions into a single unit is called encapsulation. This means data and functions are to be packed into a single unit. As you all know that in a capsule, just similar to a capsule, like in a capsule we capture the medicine powder is packed inside it. Similar way, if we pack data and functions into a single unit, this will be referred as encapsulation. Next, we'll talk about data abstraction. Data abstraction means the act of representing the essential features without including the background details. This means we will be concerned only with the interface. We have nothing to do with the internal functions. the essential features without including the background details. This means we'll be involved only with the interface. That means we'll be concerned only with the interface, and we have nothing to do with the internal function of the parts. For example, I have a mobile phone. I want to click a picture with that. So I know I have a camera software over there. I will click on this camera icon and my camera starts, and I click the image. What function is happening inside the phone, what mechanism is involved inside the phone, I have nothing to do with that. This is called data abstraction. Let me take another example. If I'm riding a bike, I should know what is the use of brake, when to use a brake, clutch, gear, etc. I have nothing to do with the internal mechanism of the gear, how the gearbox is moving, how the gear is shifting, how the engine is working. So I have nothing to do with the internal functioning of a thing. So this is called data abstraction, in which only the essential features will be displayed to you and background details will be hidden for you. This concept is known as data abstraction. Next, we'll talk about inheritance. Inheritance means the process by which a derived class or a child class acquires the properties of the base class or the parent class. Means one class acquires the properties and behaviors, that is attributes and functions of another class, that is the parent class. Like suppose you all have some vehicles at home. So that vehicle belongs to your parents, but you have the authority to use it. Since you are a child of your parent, so you have the authority to use it. Similarly, in programming also, when we have a superclass or a parent class and subclasses, subclasses have the authority to use those attributes of the parent class. This is called inheritance. That means this you have got an inheritance. Next, we'll talk about polymorphism. Polymorphism means any function which behaves differently under different situations. This is called polymorphism. And next, to work Java programming, we need BlueJ. So we'll have a brief introduction of this. BlueJ is basically an IDE, that is Integrated Development Environment, and this will help us to run Java program. And there's one more feature called Java Development Kit. Java Development Kit is a software package which allows us to run Java programs. So for working with Java, we need two things. First is BlueJ. It will provide you the interface through which we'll run the, through which we'll write the codings, the source code. It will allow us to write codings, and JDK, that is Java Development Kit, will allow us to run the programs in an efficient manner, and if there is any error, it will display the error. So this we have discussed about BlueJ and Java Development Kit. If we talk about Java Development Kit, JDK, there are many versions of Java, like JDK 1.01, which was released in 1995, JDK 1.1, which was released in 1996, and so on. So these are the different versions of JDK, that is Java Development Kit. Java Development Kit is nothing but a software package that allows us to run Java programs. How to run Java programs in a system? So we'll start with Java programming. So first you need to open your browser, any browser. It can be Opera, it can be Mozilla Firefox, it can be Google Chrome. Here you need to type www.bluej.org. Once you open this website, you will see BlueJ site, and here you will get versions. Like if you want to install BlueJ for Windows, you can click on this. You can, if you want to install BlueJ for OS, Mac OS, click on this. If you're working on Linux, you will need this. If you're working on the platforms, you will have to download this file. So if I'm working with Windows, so I'll click on this. Once I'll click on this, it starts the download, and I'll click on this, so it will start the downloading process. So wherever you want to install, just save a package, and after it is installed, you need to run this file, you need this executable file to install it. Once you have installed BlueJay, you will have this kind of icon at the desktop, and you need to open this BlueJay file. This BlueJay software has an embedded JDK with this. Nowadays it comes embedded, and once we open this BlueJay, so it will have an interface like this. It shows that BlueJay is being opening, and this is the interface. So first, when we open, it creates like this. So first you need to make a new project. You have this menu bar, click on this project option and click on new project, and here I'll make wherever you want to save the projects. Like I'm saving in D drives. In D drives I want, like, suppose I'll select a folder like first, or where I want to save, like I want to save in this folder. Okay, project, new project, here I want to save. I'll create. In D drive I'll say first, so this will create one new project. And inside this project, you need to create a new class, because all the programs are written within a class. So we will click on this new class button, and suppose first class, that is the first program that I want to make, is welcome. So I'll write here welcome, and remember you need to click on this class button. By default it will be clicked on this class only, then press on OK button, and this will open your class. So now welcome, there is one class created with the name welcome. We need to double click on this, and the class welcome has opened. So this is the source editor of BlueJay, where we are going to perform our programs. So first I need to remove all these things. So for that I'll select all, that is Control A, and then delete. So this way I'll delete the sample program which was there. Now I'll start my coding. I'll write my first program. So to start with, so first, whenever we are working with Java program, first we need to create a class. So I'll write here public class, I'll write here welcome, because we have given the name welcome, public class welcome. Now we have created the class, we'll click on, we'll bring a curly braces, we'll insert a curly brace, then enter, then I'll write public static void main. These things I'll be explaining you later, but just now I'm showing you the sample program, like how we are going to do the codings. Click on enter. So now we have created a class, we have created a main function, because all the functions will be created inside this class only. So this public is called an access specifier. This class is a keyword which shows that we are creating a new class, and this welcome is the name of the new class that we have created. Access specifier, class is a keyword which shows that we are creating a new class, and welcome is the name of a new class. This opening curly brace shows that we have opened a new class, and inside this class we have created a main function, public static void main. Public is again access specifier, static is a keyword, main is the main function which starts execution of the program. That means the program starts executing from the main function only. So here I have opened curly braces, that means I have started the main function. Now here I'll write system dot out dot print ln, and inside this we'll give double quotes, and here I'll write welcome to Java, and here I need to give a semicolon. It is used as a terminator, and then I'll close this curly braces. This shows that I have closed this main function. Then I'll leave one more curly braces because I have to close this class also. Once you write a program, this program is known as the source code. And after writing the source program, what we need to do is we will compile this program using this button. We'll click on compile. And once the program is compiled, it will show here class compiled, no syntax error. That means there are no errors in our program and we can run the program now. So after completing this program, we need to minimize this, and we'll go here, like welcome is our class. We'll right click on this and click on void main. So this is a terminal window which shows the output of a program, and here welcome to Java is the output of our first program. Okay, now if you want to add one more line, like I want to make some changes, like here I'll write this is my first program. This system.out.println is basically a print statement which is used to give output. Whatever we'll write inside double quotes within the parenthesis of this function system.out.println, this will print as it is. Let me show you. Now I'm again compiling this. Compiling done. So I'll minimize this button. I'll click on this. I'll go to welcome. Right click on this. Click on main function, and it will show here welcome to Java. This is my first program. I have not cleared this. That's why it has come again. So if I clear it again, and then again if I run this program, terminal window, I'll get the output welcome to Java, this is my first program. So this is the terminal window where we get the output. So this is how we perform Java programs. So first we write a high level language, and this high level language, that is the source code, the compiler changes this high level language to a low level language which is executed, and we give the result. But if there is some error in this program, so in that case the compiler will show the error, and there we need to debug that error. Once we debug the error, the program will be error free, and then we can run the program, and after running the program it generates an executable file that gives the result or the output. So I hope this part is clear. Now we have discussed what is Java program, how it is executed, how it is written, how BlueJay environment works, and this was the first tutorial. In the next tutorial, I'll be explaining you about the further details.